G'day guys, welcome back. Welcome to Pouring Your Heart Out. Guess what I'm doing today? Look at these three big cups of white. I'm going to do a sandwich pour. So, a sandwich. White bread, fillings, white bread. That's what I'm doing, except white paint, coloured paint, white paint. So, that's what we're doing today. Pouring medium, same as the one I always do, I should say, for my flip cup pour. 60% glue. I'm using Elmer's Glue All, but you can use any white craft glue. You can actually use a clear craft glue if you want. So 60% of that, 40% of water. If you don't know how to do that, you can go 60 grams, 40 grams, 6 ounces, 4 ounces. 600 grams, 400 grams, as long as it's four and six, you're fine, okay? So, Montmartre paint. Here we go. We have white, that's the opaque. We have turquoise, that's opaque as well. See the little round dot there? It's colored in. That's that one there, the turquoise. This one down the end is the phthalo blue. I don't know if you can see it, the little circle's half coloured in. So that's a semi-transparent or semi-opaque. Now, this one is my navy. It's just the phthalo blue with a touch of black in it. And then this one here is the turquoise with a little bit of phthalo blue. So you can mix up your own colours. So that these two are going to be the opaques, and these are the semi-opaques. So I've just separated them. Let's put in some oil, treadmill silicone oil by Spot On, and we're going to do four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Actually, let's go five. Let's go five. Because there's only a little bit of colour, and there's a lot of white, and I'm not going to put any in the white. I'll get my gloves on. Mix that up really well. And you've heard me say it a lot of times, mix your oil up really, really well. Otherwise, you get blobs of silicone oil in your painting when you stretch your canvas out. So, and then get the oil off the stick as well. So, just give me a minute to get that done. So, as you can see, I've got 4 cups. I'm not going to do flip and drags this time. I'm just going to flip them over. So, we'll just get like a puddle. And then I'll tilt. So no oil in the white. The white is the opaque. I want the cells to drop down in the white and the white to come up around them. That's the plan anyway. I haven't done a sandwich pour for so long. It feels like it probably has been last year, you know. Now the white, I want it to be a little bit thinner than the other colors. So it leaves a little mound. Don't hold your stick way up here because you get a different look. Just hold the bottom of the stick with the top of the cup and you get a little mound. Okay? Because if you hold it way up here, you got a lot more sort of pressure on the paint as it drops down. So now I need to use 1.5 cups of white for my first layer. So let's just see how much we've got here. Now my canvas is a 30 by 60 centimeter, which is 12 by 24 inches. So it's relatively big. I mean, I have done bigger, but the flip cup pours, they use so much paint. Now I've got 1 kilo of paint here. Probably got a bit more actually. What I did with the colors, I did 30 grams of pouring medium, which is 1 ounce, and 30 grams of paint. Got to make sure I've still got half of that left for my next layer. Okay, so there's 1.5 cups in there and 1.5 cups left. So that was my paint, 30 and 30, or 1 ounce and 1 ounce. The white I did 150 grams. Now I'm just going to make sure that I've got enough of this blue to go across all 4 cups. So 150 grams of paint, sorry, 150 grams, I've got to concentrate, 150 grams of pouring medium, and I only did 130 grams of paint, so I wanted it to be a little bit thinner, so I didn't have exact same amounts. Otherwise, I find with so much white, when everything's spread out, the cells can't come up through the white if the white's too thick, and then you get these tiny little cells. But if you make your white a little bit thinner, and it just gets a nice sort of thin haze over the top of your other colours, then your cells can easily pop through. So just be aware of that. Don't make your white too thick when you're doing sandwich pours. When I'm doing my normal flip cup pours, I do the opposite. I make my white a little bit thicker because I tend to lose the white in a flip cup pour. The other colours sort of overtake it. So it's a little bit different depending on what technique you're doing. So it just takes a little bit of practice, but I'm here to help. I'm happy to help give you my maybe not so expert opinion on how I do things and why I do things. Now, the other thing you need to be aware of when you're doing a sandwich pour, choose colours that aren't too pale because you're going to dull them down with white anyway, aren't you? There's a lot of white, so don't pick pastely colors unless you know really want a very pastely painting at the end of it. But I choose pretty dark colors because I know that they're going to lighten and I still want to be able to see them, so I don't choose them to be too pale. Right, nearly there, guys. Last one. This is the turquoise with the blue added in it. So we've only got a little bit of colour here, and the rest of it's going to be all white. I just hope I don't get big blocks of white. That's the only issue. You know, having too much white and then there's not enough colour underneath it. I've had that happen before, so you've just got to practice on the size of canvas that you've got and not have too much white. Oh, I didn't bring my cloths in again, because when I did a pearl pour this morning, I took my cloths out into the other room and rinsed them, and they're still sitting there on my laundry sink. All right, here we go. Now with this one, you don't want the white to fall straight through, so try and drizzle it carefully just for the first little layer there. And then we'll come up and pour some more over the top. This is just my little half cup now that I've got here. Let's get all that out. I hope this works, you guys. It's been so long. I'm nervous about it. All right, here we go, last little cup. Now, with your stick, you can either take your stick out, but if you just hold it like that, your stick's gonna fall out. So I like to do this, that way I've got my stick wedged there, and then I can still pour. So basically what I'm gonna do now is just bring the white up so that it's level. They've all got the same amount in them. Roughly the same amount anyway. Stand back and look at them. You need a bit more, and you need a bit more, and that's basically all done. So can you see my sandwich there? My bread, my fillings and my bread. Someone said to me, why don't you do a sandwich pour with black? I haven't done that one yet. I may do one, but I'll talk to you while I'm flipping these. But I think I will have to have, like, because I'm using black as a sandwich, very light colours, you know, maybe not white because you get grey, but, you know, pale pink, pale yellow, very pale baby blue, that sort of thing. Alrighty. I want to run out and grab my cloths. Stay there. While that paint is tipping out, grab my cloths. The dogs heard me open the door. I started barking again. I'll keep the door closed so that they don't hear me. All right, there we go. Wiped my hands. Not too bad. All right, are we ready to flip these over? Now, I'm not going to do a flip and drag. I'm just going to try and just do a flip. Because if you do a drag, you get stripes. I probably get a few stripes, but I don't really want a lot of stripes. So I'm just going to flip. Let's see what happens. Oh, look at that. Look at that white coverage. I'm going to put the leftover paint just on the corners, just to wet the corners, basically. I will be tipping the paint off. But see how stripy it is when you pour it back out? And I don't really like that, so. But look at that haze, that white haze. That's a bit thick there. Now, your edges of your cup, take them all down onto one side. Because see how it's kind of messy there? We'll tip that off. So, and don't put this back again. See, look how stripy it is. I don't know why I've got that stripe. Probably because I've sort of flipped it back. This one's the best one. I was really gentle with that one. Let's see if I can do gentle again. They all come out differently. They've all got the same paint in them, you know, but they all come out differently. Yeah, see that one? I just tipped really gently. So we've got the same effect of that. Interesting, isn't it? Oh, there's a cell. All right, so at the bottom, where the last little bit of paint comes out, is always kind of messy like that, like I said to you before. So that's the side that we want to tip off first. And by the time I go left and right to get all this down, oops, what are you? We'll get rid of that. But this top looks amazing. Oh my gosh, it's heavy. Alrighty, are we ready? So, you know the drill. Left, right, and down to cover the canvas. Don't want to go straight down, otherwise these are all going to go off and you'll have blank areas. So make sure that you can cover your surface. So you touch the sides here. Now the good thing about not having stripies is I'm happy to have a little bit of movement in this painting, because I don't have all the stripes. I'm just going to help that to the sides there. Just take your time. This is the most important part. Take your time. I'm actually going to get corner catcher so I don't lose too much paint as it goes off the corner. Because as it goes off the corner, it goes off there and there as well. So you lose a lot of paint. And we don't want that. We don't want that to happen. Oh, I'm going to get my corner catcher out of my drawer. It's just a piece of cardboard. So you've got to hang on to that, push on both sides while you pick this up. Take the paint to the corner. See how those messy bits have gone off the edge now? And then bring it back. And then let go, otherwise you're going to lose too much. All right, so back again this way. Into the corner, let the paint touch the corner of the cardboard, back again, and then take it. So that's all dropped off there now. Now this white edge there, I don't like that. Take the weight of the paint back to the middle, and I'm going to get rid of that blob, and I'm going to get rid of that. Okay, and I'm just going to walk the paint so that I don't lose my shape of my cells. Okay, there it's gone. Yay, it's gone, it's gone. Big cells, those ones are huge. Oh, did I just get paint on my shirt? Now, make sure that you take your hand around, because if you've got paint dripping off your gloves, and then you take your hands across your canvas, 9 times out of 10, it's going to drop right into the middle of your painting. So don't do that. Make sure you go around like that with your hands. Okay, so now what we want to do is, now we want to torch and see what we can get using my big boy blowtorch. All right, now we should get some really pretty cells up through the white haze. I'm just going to turn that off for a minute. This white here, it's very thick. Unlikely to get any cells through that and that. This, I'm still going to be tilting some of that off. I don't mind that bit of white there. We may get a couple of cells through there, but when you've got a thick amount like that, you tend not to get cells through there. But I don't mind. It's kind of a little bit of negative space. Now go really carefully. The cells tend to pop up really easily because you've got a very thin layer of opaque paint over the top of the cells. So they do tend to kind of spring up and go, I'm here! A little bit easier than they do on other, you know, flip cut pours that might have a more thick layer of paint on them. I'm just concentrating now, going around in little circles, putting the cells where I want them. I don't want to get too close. See, I torched that corner there. There's really not much happening there. It's just popping bubbles. Okay, so that's my first round of cells. I'm going to go back up this end. I'm going to go again with the torch and encourage a few more cells to pop up in the areas that I haven't got any. Oops, I got a bit close there. There's a caterpillar happening. So with this, I may go around again. I probably will. If the white is a bit thick in some areas and the cells aren't coming up, after I've stretched the paint and covered part of the canvas, so I'm not getting anything here, I'll come around again with the torch and I'll torch again after I've thinned out that white, because then I'll get more cells up through the white if I've thinned it out a little bit more. And I thin it out by stretching it. So how's it looking so far? Now I'm just sort of concentrating on the edges a little bit. But here I'm not getting much. And here I'm not getting much. I don't know why. Go a little bit closer here. See, I'm not really getting much there. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that for now. I'm going to stretch this, grow the cells a bit, stretch the white out, and then I'm going to torch again and get some more cells up. Probably should have tilted that white off a little bit more, but we shall see. I can't get back to that corner now. Once you've done with up here, that's it. Don't even try to go back there because you'll just overstretch everything. All right, you can see the weight of the paint in the center there where it's moving. But I need to get it to come over here, which is a bit tricky. But, oh, we'll do it. We'll do it. All right, here we go. I'm going to have to go all the way over there. And then back. I don't want to cover the corner just yet. Let's wet that. I'm going to lose all those gorgeous cells there, but can't do anything about that. Yes, you can go. You're a big blob. All right, now, see how they're growing quite a lot already. And these big ones are quite a lot bigger now. Now I'm just going to wet that canvas because I want the paint to go over that corner now. So that's going to be my last thing that I'm going to do. I'm going to go all the way over there, which is a bit hard to do. I'll get rid of that caterpillar while I'm doing it. Okay, so we've got big cells in this. Oh, I like big cells and I cannot lie. Okay, so now, look at that big white stripe. I don't know how that happened. Now I'm going to torch again and I'm going to bring up some smaller cells. So hopefully I'll be able to get some in these areas that are quite blank. torch is nearly empty. I have to get a little bit closer to the canvas because it's a bit empty. It hasn't got much power left in it. Oh, look, I got too close there. Oh, dear. I wonder if I can get cells inside those blobs because I don't like the blobs very much. Yeah, my torch is almost empty. It's not... Don't stick your finger in front of it, woman. It's not doing very much, so I'm getting a little bit closer. I'm going to have to fill it up. Well, not fill it up. I have to change the can. This is one of those that the can screws off. Oh, got anything left? Or have you gone? I think he's gone. Oh, no, tiny bit. I'll have to have a memorial service for him. He's been good. Yes, you have. You've been good. Now, then there's nothing going to happen through here. Oh, he's gone. I can smell the stuff coming out. So that just comes off like that. So that can go. I'll just get a new one. Let me find another can. Oh yes, I have. Oh, here we go. I get these from Bunnings. These are the cheaper ones, actually. You can get in the camping section. You see, much cheaper than getting them everywhere else. So that little slot there goes into that, and then you twist. Now the only thing with having a brand new can on, it can sometimes be a bit of a flamethrower. Oh goodness. Turn it down. Got it turned down really low. So just gotta be careful. Don't shake it. Now I'm gonna have to go up high because he's gonna be really powerful because he's full of butane again now. Hello, new can. Welcome. Hope you're gonna be good to me over the next 6 months while we're painting together. Does anyone else talk to their equipment? Or am I the only weirdo? Let's see if I can get anything through this white here. I don't think so, but... ones. Wow. Okay. I think that's about enough. I tend to get a bit carried away, don't I? I love these. I love the colors in those. Now, as I said, a bit of a white stripe there, but hey, it happens. It's just part of it. It would have been nice if there was like another white stripe up here. If you're feeling really game, you could pour a little bit of extra white on there, but I'm not going to. I must have had just, this cup must have had more white in it than the others, maybe, I don't know. Now the other thing, do I want to grow these cells, the little baby cells? If you want to grow your baby cells, all you do is just do this. Don't actually tip any paint off, just move. I like to move it. You're just moving your paint up and down. And that'll just, it'll just grow them a little bit. But look, I don't mind. What do you think? Do you like it? Do you love it? These big blobby things here, I'm not in love with. But that may have been a drop of, or two drops of silicone that I didn't stir enough. But we've got big ones, we've got medium ones, we've got little tiny ones. We've got a little bit of caterpillars happening. So anyway, there we go. Sandwich pour. What do you think? What do you think? Do you like it? Let me get you down for a close-up. I'll get these gloves off. Let's see what you reckon. So, oh, I've got paint on my shirt. So just going over again the sandwich pour. You need to have your white thinner. You've seen what happens when your white's a bit thick over there. Too much white, you won't get anything through. In saying that, because the mix is thinner, you get bigger cells. So what I'll do is next time I do a sandwich pour, and some of you may really love big cells. I prefer maybe smaller ones that are better shaped and don't start looking wobbly. So what we can do, and I'll do that next time, I'll pick another color and I'll show you the difference of maybe torching later because the mix is so much thinner. This is my favorite. Oh, I love these. Look at those. Love those ones there. So pretty. So next time when I do a sandwich pour, I'll flip the cups over, I'll tilt, cover one side of the canvas, I'll tilt, do the other side of the canvas so that the whole thing is covered, and then torch, or maybe almost cover the second side and then torch, and then you've only got a little bit of stretching to do, which means your cells don't get overstretched. Anybody would like to see that, the difference? Oh, look at this one little blue cell sitting in the middle of the white there. It's a bit of a snowstorm, isn't it? So really pretty backgrounds. I probably could have even got away with less blue. Because normally when you do a flip cup pour, you lose so much white. But on this one, the white definitely shines through. So there we go. A blue sandwich pour. Hope you've enjoyed that little video. I'll turn off the ring light. That's better because I can't stand on the other side without the ring light shining into everything. So there it is there. And yeah, love it. Well, except those two in the middle. Don't look at them. Don't look at them. We'll try again. Like I said, it's been so long since I've done a sandwich pour, I'd kind of forgotten what to do and how the thinner paint reacts. But yeah, I'll do another one and we'll torch later and I'll show you the difference. Okay. All right. Let me know what you think of it anyway, whether you like the big cells, those big ones, big blobby ones in the middle. Do they bother you? They kind of bother me. All right. Thanks for watching, you guys. Love you all. Stay safe. Bye for now.